Saul assembled a small army to do battle with the Philistine soldiers whenever they threatened the livelihood of the tribes of Israel. Authority and protection. Just as they had requested of Samuel, the people of Israel now had a king to lead them. However, all these events caused Saul to become arrogant, and he turned his back on the laws which God had made for his people.
Is Samuel here?
I'm sure he'll be here soon.
He's late. He's very late.
Before setting out to do battle, a sacrificial offering ceremony to God was indispensable. But Samuel, who was to conduct the ceremony, was late in arriving.
Father, let us wait for a little while longer. I am sure he will be here very soon.
Became impatient and decided to act in place of Samuel. In doing this, Saul committed blasphemy, for only a priest could conduct a sacrificial ceremony. Even a king was not granted this privilege. Of divine law, he uttered terrifying words, saying that Saul had provoked God's wrath, and therefore the Lord would divest Saul of his kingdom.
I am the king. I decide everything.
When the people of Israel heard of God's censure of Saul, they no longer revered Saul and turned their backs on him.
If King Saul should find out that you have consecrated one of my sons as a king,
he would have him killed. And he would probably kill you and all of your other sons as well. But we must do God's bidding. Boys, are they your sons?
I have another one, my seventh son. He is tending the sheep, but he will be back before long. This is David.
Tell me, sir, why have I been called here?
The Lord has appointed you the king of his people. The Spirit of the Lord shall dwell in you for eternity. You will grow up, and the people will welcome you as their king.
Again!
Yes!
King Saul was now coming to an end. The skill and beauty of David's music carried all the way from his father's house to the ears of Saul's attendants, and they called David to the court to soothe the troubled soul of the king. It was the court official's intention to comfort the king in his despair. Saul was now beginning to realize that he no longer felt the indication of God being near him. Saul's heart surged with uneasiness and fretfulness.
Over me, all of the Philistines will become your slaves.
Your Highness, the Philistine troops are advancing.
What?
It is that giant again.
Your Highness?
Are you all right?
Silence!
Let me challenge Goliath.
He is a giant, over 9 feet tall, and as heavy as a mountain. How can someone like you, who is as small as a mountain bitch, challenge such an opponent?
When I was a shepherd and wandered in the desert, the Lord saved me from lions, bears, and wolves, and the Lord will surely help me defeat Goliath. Challenge you in the name of the Lord. I need no sword or shield.
Come closer. I shall feed your flesh to the birds in the sky and the beasts in the field.
Thank you very much, Your Highness.
And Saul gave his daughter Michal to David for his wife. By doing this, Saul thought to gain greater prestige for himself throughout the land of Israel.
Well, I am the king. David is but a mere shepherd. I am the king. The throne is mine, and mine alone!
What are you doing, Father? David, you must run!
Go after him! Kill the shepherd David, the son of Jesse!
Lord, please protect me. Does not forsake those who love him.
Why do you speak ill of this king of yours? I warned all of you. A king will steal your daughters and make your sons into soldiers, and he will take your crops for taxes. And you said, it does not matter. You wanted a king. So the Lord anointed a king.
But Saul is a corrupt king.
Do you understand that having a king is not the important thing? What is important is having a just king. David!
Prophet Samuel, I shall stay in this land to praise God and become a prophet. I came to stay here with you.
You shall have another king after King Saul. That man will be a righteous king. Slay the best sheep and prepare dates and figs. Today is a day to be celebrated.
David lived with Samuel in the town of Na'yuf, near Ramah. King Saul tried to arrest David. He sent his envoys once, twice, three times. But each time, when they arrived in Na'yuf, they were overwhelmed by the Lord's Spirit and could not kill David. Instead, they faithfully followed Samuel's words. Saul became more and more enraged, because he had waited such a long time to hear the news of David's death.
The moment you find David, kill him immediately. Do you understand?
Oh, King, I had you in my hand, and yet I did not kill you.
David, come down from there.
Why? And for how far do you intend to pursue me?
David, my son, come back to me.
Have I committed a sin? If I have, you must tell me what it is. What have I done to make you hate me so much? What did I do?
David... Do not chase me. Enough. David, I wanted you to stay by me. I wanted to forgive you. But in spite of myself, I am overcome with an urge to kill you. What is happening to me?
From that time on, Saul never saw David again.
It's the Philistine army. Thousands, no, tens of thousands of them. More than the sands of the desert.
Why? Why does the Lord desire to pass the kingdom of Israel into the hands of the enemy? I wish to summon the spirit of a certain man.
And whose spirit did you wish to summon?
I wish to speak with Samuel, the prophet Samuel.
Oh, spirit of Samuel, the prophet, spirit, come in and gather now. We call your spirit to come in and come in with spirit. Come in to us.
I wish to hear what lies ahead of us.
God has forsaken you. God will hand you, your sons, and all the people of Israel to the Philistines. God has delivered your kingdom into the hands of David.
Why don't you ask God?
There is no answer. Day after day, since the death of Samuel, the Almighty has remained silent.
But Father, you have forbidden shaman from dwelling in your kingdom. They tried to challenge the mysteries of the past and the future. They even tried to challenge God. The Lord will punish us.
I shall fight. I will fight to the end.
has forsaken you. God will hand you, your sons, and all the people of Israel to the Philistines. God has delivered your kingdom into the hands of David.
Ah!